What is going on, you guys? It is Erica Bernie finally coming back with another video. So I was running not even late, but I was running on time and I didn't really have time to record right before I actually got to work. But right now it's around 7:40 and it's Labor Day, so therefore it's only low manning today, and I was able to come in this morning and teach a little bit of combatives, obviously. So if y'all are wondering what uniform I'm in the combatives uniform. But again, it is low manning today, so therefore I'm allowed to actually go home today and hang out with the wifey that is actually still sleeping. But I'm gonna bring you guys around today. I'm excited for today and whatever that we're gonna do today. So I hope you guys enjoyed this video, and yeah. But before I head home, I'm getting a white chocolate mocha because I want one, and a reduced fat turkey bacon, because I'm about to go do some little work right now before I actually head home. Alright, so right now it is going to be nap time until Jade wakes up, which is probably gonna be like 30 minutes, but
I can hear your laughter coming waves across the shore. Oh, maybe you could fly my kite, babe. Maybe you could fly my kite, babe. I can hear your laughter coming waves across the shore. Oh, maybe you could fly my kite, babe. Maybe you could fly my kite, babe.
What is going on, you guys? This is Erica Bernie finally coming back with another video. So I know it's kind of all over the place. I just had a vlog and then all of a sudden now I'm talking to you guys. But it's because I've been doing a lot of stuff. It's red face, so my head's in the game. And again, I need to make sure that I'm taking care of my soul just before I try to do anything else. And then whenever I do, I have time off. I want to hang out with my wife with the like few hours I do have. And then I'm just usually just tired. But let's get on with this video. So today's topic is about APFT, the Army Physical Fitness Test. Talking about that, today my trainees took the red face PT test, and it's becoming a big thing, the red face PT test. It's to the point where now, and it just came out recently, that if you don't get a certain score for the PT test, they'll push you back to FTC, FTU, whatever they call it, at your post. And it's the physical training, or the fitness training unit or company, in order for you to actually get physically fit. Because there's a lot of people that actually come to basic training and think it's going to be easy when they haven't really done a push-up or sit-up or run for 2 miles in their life. And sometimes people in the beginning, they don't really have their mindset of being physically fit before they get here. So my advice is to actually work on it. Don't think that you're gonna come to basic training that you can absolutely not run beforehand, not do any type of sit-up or any type of physical training, and think basic training is going to definitely just make me able to magically do X amount of push-ups, X amount of sit-ups, and run 2 miles at a good time. It's not. Like, it does help and get your score better, but if you're already like not as great as you should be, or just can't even do anything, when you get to basic training, it's probably gonna be very difficult for you, because you want to be physically ready, physically somewhat fit, in order to pass doing the 2 mile or the 2 minute push-up, the 2 minute sit-ups, and the 2 mile run. Because eventually, in the long term, you already know that the new PT test is coming out and it's definitely much harder. So right now, just work on your push-ups, sit-ups, and run. A lot of people ask me, what can I do in order to make sure I'm physically ready for basic training? And again, you go through many obstacles, you go through many rocks, you go through many things in order to actually feel like tired and all that. But to be physically ready in order for you to actually pass basic training is to be able to do a push-up, be able to do your sit-ups, and be able to run for 2 miles. And 2 miles is probably the minimum. Eventually, in the beginning, you'll be going through AGRs, which is ability group run, and maybe the first run will be a mile or a mile and a half. That's just to introduce you on what's about to come, because starting after a few weeks, you're going to be starting running 2 miles, 3 miles, 4 miles, 30, 60, 61, 20s, all these other things. And not only just doing PT in the morning, you'll have to go through ranges, have to ruck, have to go through obstacles after doing PT in the morning, all that. So being physically ready is is a thing that you need to do before you come to basic combat training. Because if you think you can magically be able to do a push-up without putting in the work, it's not going to happen. I can honestly say when I went to basic training, I couldn't do a push-up. And I was somewhat physically okay because I ran. I made sure I ran at least every other day before leading up to basic training. And I did sports when I was in high school. So I was already in that mentality of, all right, it's going to be tough. I need to push myself and all that. Therefore, it was easy for me to go through basic combat training. I just needed to work on my form for push-up. And other than that, I was good to go. For you, in your own time, you need to do it on your own time is work on your push-ups, your sit-ups, and your run. That's the main thing that's going to help you pass basic combat training. Because if you can't do any of those three things, then you won't be able to pass basic combat training. Because every 6 months, you're supposed to be taking a PT test. And that's how it is. You need to be able to pass every PT test. It just doesn't only matter in basic training. It matters through your military career. Also, when you go to basic combat training, let's say you can't do a push-up, right? And you have X amount of days or weeks in order for you to lead up to the PT test that you need to pass. The thing is, if you think, oh, I'll just do the PT and all that and it'll get me a good score, no. You need to do it on your off time. Whenever drill sergeant is telling you, all right, do 10 push-ups right after you fall out formation. Don't just knock out 10 and it'd be crappy. Knock out 10 good push-ups and eventually, yes, you might be tired, but when it leads up to your PT test, then you can knock out as many push-ups as you can. It's possible. All I would say is get ready for your PT test. If you wonder what's the main thing that you should worry about, your PT test is your push-ups, your sit-ups, and your run. Those are the three main things that you should worry about before going in basic combat training. Don't worry about rucking. Don't worry about all these other things if you're physically not ready to do a push-up, sit-up, or run. Because those are the three things that will hold you back, that will stop you from graduating. If you can't do those three things, they will not let you graduate. And now it's becoming, in red phase, if you don't get a certain score for red phase, they will push you back. We're allowed to push you back. Go get sent to FTU, FTC, and they will build you up in order to get you physically ready, and then they'll send you back to basic training and you'll start again from day zero. But that's it. I hope you guys enjoyed this video, and if you guys have any topics, go ahead, write down in the comments below. Also, I'm going to be trying to at least answer one question every comment that happens, and if you get the top like and all that, I'm going to do this little thing where I'll end the video with answering one question at least. But I hope you guys enjoyed this video. I'll see you guys next time.